New tools emerging in biotechnology has the potential to change the way we're viewing modern plant breeding. This could call for a discussion of how we define GMO. So a group of scientists from different fields address different aspects of introducing the concept of rewilding to modern plant breeding.
All our crop plants today of today, they once were wild. So they were growing in nature and were not thinking of becoming crop plants. Now we're in the situation where we need to get more, we would like to have more agricultural output without increasing the impacts, the negative impacts we have on land with pesticides, herbicides, and fertilizers. So we want to increase output in a sustainable way. And now it becomes a goal. It becomes an obvious goal if we can furnish today's crop plants that today are very sensitive and need a lot of care with some of the properties of the wild plants, their relatives. Yeah? Go back to the reverse breeding, and this is what we call rewilding. And we still do not really know that what can the power of this, but it appears that these methods offer a very precise technology that we much faster and with several genes at one time can be able to go back to wild type properties of our crop plants and in this way strengthen them. Yeah?
So the current EU legislation in Europe is a challenge for these new emerging techniques. As an example, there would be no difference between transgenic and cisgenic crops.
From the legal point of view, there is no difference. The point is that if we have original genes harboring in the plant, then the concept is, yes, but that might indicate it should be approved. But the all-over concept is that the technology itself might cause a risk and therefore subject to this complex regime of analyzing, assessment, and approval.
In this paper, we discuss the public resistance against GMO in relation to philosophical theory.
Now, you might then ask, one thing is what these theories say, but another thing is that we have the fact that a large part of the population simply don't like the idea of GM crops. Isn't there some sort of democratic problem? Isn't there some sort of democratic reason to say that we ought to have a restrictive legislation about GM crops for the mere reason that many people simply don't like the idea? So if we accept that view, then while it's still true that there's a large public resistance, at least in Europe, against GM, and it's also true that we should respect these views as fully legitimate views that people are totally entitled to have, it's not obvious that this should mandate a very restrictive legislation.
And we investigate the consumer opinion on the concept of naturalness in GM products.
We know from sociological studies that this aspect of naturalness is important to consumers. So that opens up the question that basically is what is in the paper, that we might think that if such products are produced, there could be a segment of consumers that actually are willing to buy these products as much or as conventional bred products.
The Are We Ready for Back to Nature crop breeding paper introduces the concept of rewilding by new biotech-based tools. Tapping on expertise of a wide field of experts, the aim is to open up a discussion on how GMO should be perceived.